If you had to get into a bar fight and you can only take two fighters with you, what do you take, Teddy?
Listen, what would I take? You never know who somebody is until you're in that situation. Sometimes you watch guys even in the ring, and you know, Tyson's a good example. Everyone would have thought he'd be a guy that you would take. You never want to take him. He'd disappear on you. I mean, you know, and that was shown when finally someone stood up to him with Buster Douglas and then with Holyfield. Those guys stood up. But you would have thought that, but you would have been wrong. You really never know what somebody really is until they're really tested, truly tested. Not just on the fringes and on the surface, but truly tested, where they're in a difficult, dangerous, threatening situation where they don't have the upper hand and they have to find a way out. Then you find out what a person is. You find out what a friend is, and you find out what a fighter is. You know, friends are the same as fighters.
How so?
In a way that they got to be tested to find out how good they are. But I think Golovkin would be a guy that I don't know. He might be, you know, he comes from that heritage. He comes from a tough background, not an overprivileged background, where maybe honor and loyalty would mean something, and would mean sticking with you even though it was threatening, even though it was dangerous. You know, maybe he was brought up that way. I'm just guessing. I'm guessing that maybe part of his culture would have taught him that, you know, that he wouldn't disappear on you, because there would be something else at stake. How he would feel about that, you know, how he would have to answer to that, and that's what I look for in people, is somebody that has the connection to those kind of things and they care about those kind of things.
Teddy, who do you think will carry the boxing torch once Pacquiao's gone, Mayweather's gone? Who do you see as the fighter?
Golovkin's one of them. I mean, Kovalev is getting everyone's attention too. You know, two European-based fighters, but I'd like to find some American ones too. But
I'll find my
guess. You know, there's always somebody out there. I don't know if Gary Russell will wind up being able to pass the test. You know, when he's put into that position. I don't know. I know he's talented. I know he was, you know, one of the Olympic fighters. That means that he was fighting the best fighters for a period of time in the world. In the amateurs, he has the experience. I know he has talent, but I don't know if he has the full package. I don't know if he knows, because he hasn't been put in that situation yet. But, you know, it'll usually come from the kids that were in the amateur Olympic programs that, or at least in the national programs, that had a good amateur background. And maybe they didn't quite get over the hump to win the Olympics or to make the Olympic team, but they had enough experience of internationally to and have the kind of skill sets that make them better pros than amateurs. You know, those skills didn't translate maybe in the amateur game, body punching, you know, toughness, but they will translate in the pro game.
Thank you, Teddy. For ESNewsReport.com, I'm Constantino Garcia reporting. You can follow me on Twitter @Constantino.